Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. Lecture number 2 on Zakat, the formal charity. It's a form of ibadat, beta, and we have done in the, I've explained you in detail in the chapter of Namaz, Salat, in the lecture of Salat, that ibadat is essentially realizing the truth of our existence and responding to that realization befittingly. So for that, beta, Allah has prescribed certain formal rituals, formal. I gave you an example last time that you wear, on certain occasions, you wear, the written on the invitation card, dress code is formal, which you have to adhere to, okay? And otherwise, you can have your casual things, or casual lounge suits or whatever. Now, zakat is, God says, just like the namaz, where Allah says that it is the right of God Almighty, and you have to remember God at all times profoundly. But the bare minimum level God says is the namaz, formal namaz. If you don't offer that on time, God will ask you in the hereafter. Do not let that happen to you. Learn your namaz. Start offering your 5-time prayers. You are now entering, you have actually entered. You are now called young adults. So apart from all the other things or your aspirations, namaz also comes in now. So develop this conscious relationship with namaz. So these are the rights of God. For that you offer namaz. The bare minimum requirement, Allah says, are the 5 times formal first namaz. Similarly, Allah says human rights. You can give as much in charity as you want. You want to help others, but there's those prescribed, which is called zakat. So zakat is a charity actually. But the only difference is it has a certain percentage. Okay, beta? So the relationship of zakat with infaq. Infaq means spending in the way of God, is similar to the relationship of salat with zikr. Zikr is remembering God. Theek hai na? Bahut infaq karo. Zakat minimum requirement. Bahut zikr karo, namaz minimum requirement. Okay, beta. And like I said before in Surah Tawbah, ayat number 5 and ayat number 11, Allah says that Allah mentions the 2 things which makes a person stand out as a Muslim, who will be recognized as a Muslim, who will be given rights as a Muslim in a Muslim state. Are if he offers praise and zakat. And God says after that, leave his way. Don't get after him for fasting or hajj or all other things. If you want to inculcate those things, use it through preaching, through nice manners and preaching. But you cannot force them. Zakat, government will take it. If you remember, if you know better, even in a state like Pakistan now, zakat is deducted from the bank accounts on 1st of Ramzan every year. So it's a government institute. Government will take it, state will take it. See, so zakat is being deducted. So this is proof in itself that zakat is the state's responsibility. We have to do that. And namaz for that matter, the government will ask, should ask to offer namaz. This is what the Quran says. Theek hai beta? See, the Quran mentions the 2 together. However, if they repent and establish praise and pay zakat, then open the way for them. And this is the 5th ayat of Surah 9. And the 11th ayat says, however, if they repent, establish praise and pay zakat, then they shall be your brothers in faith. Phir wo aapke bhai hai. Equal rights. We've done this. Actually, why does God want us to do infaq? Why does God want us to do charity? Whereas the money that we earn, the degree you are getting in PIMD, for instance, you're working hard, getting your GPAs and always concerned about your assignments and, you know, you don't miss any classes, and then when you go on to do your jobs, inshallah, you'll be getting your careers and jobs and all that. It's all your hard-earned money. Yet Allah says, from that hard-earned money, give something to in my way. Why does God say that? Let's see this. There are several passages of the Quran that together help us in learning why God wants us to do infaq. Because in reality, everything in this world belongs to God. ठीक है बेटा, the way He has designed the laws of distributing this risk, this sustenance, it is not necessary that we earn as much as we work hard. ये जरूरी तो नहीं होता ना. So, although God encourages us to plan and to strive to earn, at the end of the day, obviously it is only God who decides the provision for human beings. Now, since this world is a place of trial and tribulation, this place is not a place, world is not a place of rewards and punishment. That comes later in the hereafter. There are trials and tribulations. The God says that He wants to test both of us, both of those categories, to the ones who are given more sustenance, the one who are given less sustenance, and even the ones who are given half of them, okay? Nipatullah. So because He wants to test if there's somebody who has been given more, God says, does he realize the share of the poor in his wealth or he doesn't? If he doesn't, God says it is defiance in his scheme. Uske khilaf ye baghi hai. He rebels against the scheme of God Almighty, which God doesn't like. So in God's scheme, therefore, there is a definite portion of sustenance for the poor in the wealth of the rich, which if undelivered to them will constitute defiance of his scheme, like I said. That is why he condemns extravagant spending. Fazul kharchi isliye haram hai aur gandi cheez hai, an accumulation of wealth. Allah said these are the partners of Satan, of Shaitan, who do these things. There's this great example of Karun in the Quran, which Allah has given us to given mentioned in the Quran. All those things that I've shared with you are from the Quran. To God belongs all that is in the heavens and the earth. This is Surah Al-Baqarah. Earning is not necessarily linked with effort or talent. This is the Quran again, Surah Bani Israel, great surah. The one who desires the transitory things of this life, dunya ki cheez jo chahta hai, we grant him such things as we please. You know, we give it to him as we please, zyada kam jo bhi ho, aur jisko bhi hum de, to whom we want. Then we condemn him to hell, where he will burn, disgraced and rejected. Agar aap dunya ke talib honge aur dunya kamate reh jayenge, then you know, God has, you know, he might just give you a lot of wealth to give, to make you more, to test you more. And in the end, I'm sorry, he says, that person will be condemned to hell. And the one who desires the life of the hereafter and strives for it as best as he can. Excellent sentence. You know what God said? I do not burden any soul with more than it can bear. These are in matters of religion, only religion. See, this is exactly what he says. And one who desires the life of the hereafter and strives for it as best as he can, provided he is a believer in God, the endeavor of such person shall be accepted. Allah kehta hai, I'll accept his endeavors. We bestow on all these as well as those out of the bounties of your lords, of your Lord. The bounties of your Lord are not confined. See how we have exalted some over others. Yeah, I'm trying to tell you that earning is not necessarily linked with effort or talent. We will work hard. But Allah says, see how we have exalted some over others, and certainly the hereafter is more exalted and greater in excellence. This is here for a test. You understand? God decides about the provisions of His creation. God grants abundantly His provisions to whom He wills, and sparingly to whom He pleases. The unbelievers rejoice in the life of this world, but brief indeed is the comfort of this worldly life as compared to the life in the hereafter. See, this is self-explanatory. This is Surah Ra'd, Ayah 26, 13 Surah. Children, pick up the Quran read it in your own native language. It's in Arabic only because it's in Arabic because it was revealed on Prophet Muhammad, whose native language was Arabic, and his first addressee's language was Arabic. Your language and my language is either English or Urdu or language Punjabi, whatever. If you have the Quran there, fine, otherwise even these are the languages we know, we can easily read also. Read the Quran in your own language, for God's sakes. Yeah, let's start there. Let's become a student of the Quran in this blessed month. You see, this is so simple. It is so simple. I'm going to repeat this. God grants abundantly His provisions. Allah jisko chahta hai rizq deta hai khul ke, to whom He wills, and sparingly to whom He wills. Jisko chahta hai tang karta hai. The unbelievers rejoice in this life of this world. Jo na manne wale is duniya mein karte na aish karte hain. But brief indeed is the comfort of this worldly life. Allah kehta hai ye to this will finish as compared to the life in the hereafter. इससे सिंपल क्या और बात होगी कुरान में. एक्सीलेंट आयत. अल्लाह, वी हैव डन दिस इन सूरा कोहेरेंस इन सूरा यूनिटी व्हेन वी डिड सूरा जुमा इन द थर्ड पैराग्राफ वेयर अल्लाह सेज आफ्टर यू ऑफर योर जुमा प्रेयर्स स्प्रेड इन द लैंड ऑफ गॉड टू सीक हिज बाउंटी. अल्लाह का फजल तलाश करो. तो माल जो है ना, माल इज इज बाउंटी. माल बुरी चीज़ नहीं होती. इफ़ यू अर्न इट थ्रू हलाल मीन्स, इट इज़ द बिगेस्ट बाउंटी ऑफ गॉड ऑलमाइटी, बिकॉज यू कैन एक्चुअली हेल्प अदर्स. यू कैन हैव अ गुड लाइफ इन दुनिया एंड इन आखरत. व्हाट इज़ द दुआ सप्लिकेशन ऑफ अल्लाह टू अल्लाह एट्रीब्यूटेड टू द होली प्रॉफिट. सूरह बकरा में है ना, रब्बना आतिना फिद दुनिया हसनत व फिल आखिरत हसनत व क़िना अज़ाबन नार. होल एनकंपसिंग दुआ. ओ अल्लाह, मेक दिस लाइफ फॉर मी गुड, द लाइफ हियर आफ्टर गुड, एंड सेव मी फ्रॉम द हेल फायर. फ्रॉम आवर बर्थ हियर टिल इटर्निटी, द होल पैकेज इज इन वन वर्स. वन वर्स, रब्बना आतिना फिद दुनिया हसनत वफिल आखिरत हसनत व क़िना अज़ाबन नार. जस्ट अ फैंटास्टिक पीस ऑफ प्रेयर. तो ये वही है, व्हेन यू फिनिश द प्रेयर्स देन डिस्पर्स थ्रू द लैंड एंड सीक द बाउंटी ऑफ गॉड एंड रिमेंबर गॉड फ्रीक्वेंटली सो दैट यू मे प्रॉस्पर. ये सब वो मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ कि रिस्क जो है, इट इज गॉड्स डिविजन, it is God's provision. You may work hard like hell, you might end up earning less than somebody who has just had a great time PhD and didn't do anything, and that is there, that is a test. But that doesn't mean you also start doing it. You all of you have to strive hard in life, which you all do at all times. Nobody is sitting idle. If I am delivering a lecture, I'm fasting, and giving a 1 hour lecture is not easy. And mashallah, there is load shedding going on. And the light has come, but I have to keep the fan off because that disturbs the recording. So I'm also seeking God's bounty, by the way. Now, because of that bounty that we have, God expects the rich to give to the poor. Simple. This is 63rd surah, 63rd ayat number 10, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Spend in the cause of God out of the sustenance which we have bestowed on you before the time when death will come to any one of you, and he shall say, see what he will say, that person, O Lord, if only you would reprieve me a little, thodi si mohlat de de, while then I would give out everything in charity and be among the righteous. मुझे मौका दे दे, मैं यार अपना माल ज़कात में दे दूँ, चैरिटी में. The time is up. So we have to, देखो बेटा, that is why I ask you to to develop a conscious relationship with God, with our existence, with our environment, with the human beings around us, with the fact that why somebody is earning more and somebody is earning less, whereas both have had the same degrees. We have two brothers, twin brothers, earning differently, because this is God's plan. He wants to test. If you are earning more, you have to acknowledge, recognize the share of your brethren and your sisters in it, who haven't done well because one reason or the other. Look at these fingers. They are all unequal. The brothers, sisters are all unequal. They cannot have same earnings. Somebody can be more qualified than you, yet you will be maybe earning 10 times more than him or her. It means that particular portion of earning is your brothers or sisters, right? It's for us to realize this. Realize this. You remember the three words I shared with you? I hope you remember them. Sympathy, empathy, apathy. Sympathy is, I feel sympathetic towards your situation, which is fine. Empathy, I stand in your shoes and realize your predicament. Then I realize that he or she is in a big trouble and I fulfill your needs because now I feel I'm wearing your shoes now. Apathy with an A, which means neither sympathy nor empathy. A stupid thing. Empathy means an approach where you don't have any feelings. So don't have those feelings. Develop the feelings of empathy. So Zakat is all about empathy. In God's scheme, there is a portion of sustenance for the poor in the wealth of rich. कितनी जबरदस्त बात है. देखो कुरान अब क्या कहेगा. 78 सूरा आयत 24-25. गॉड फेयरिंग पीपल आर दोज हु सेट असाइड अ ड्यू शेयर इन देयर वेल्थ फॉर द आस्किंग नीडी एंड द डिप्राइव्ड. सिंपल यार, इसको क्या समझाना है मैंने. अब है ना ये बात. डिवेलप दिस. गिफ्ट योर रिलेटिव्स दे ड्यू. व्हाट इज ड्यू? And to the needy and to the wayfarers. Beautiful, yaar. Jo zaruratmand hain, jo musafir hain, jo aapke aziz wa karib hain, maa baap hain, unko give their due. You know what is due? For instance, you have that Lesco bill or Sui gas bill, 1500 rupees. So you say, I have this bill due by such and such date that I have to pay this. So this says, give to your relatives their due. तो उनका हक है वो दे दो. वो आपका पैसा नहीं है. आपको शौक है एलिगेटर शूज, स्किन शूज का. एलिगेटर शूज, स्किन शूज आर वेरी, लेदर शूज आर वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. यू कैन बाय देम, डोंट बाय हंड्रेड ऑफ देम. आई मीन इफ यू वेरी रिच, बाय 10 ऑफ देम. बट यू नो, इफ शी आर अफोर्डेबल, यू कैन बाय रोलेक्स वॉच इफ यू कैन अफोर्ड, बट नॉट टू शो ऑफ टू योर पुअर, not that well-to-do brother, and you are doing that. Don't do that. Yeah. Ab dekho na, those who accumulate wealth and don't spend in the way of God are condemned. Jo maal jama karke rakhte hain aur kharchte nahi hai, wo to they are in for a tough time in the hereafter. I'm telling you, read the Quran beta in your language to understand. I'm going to read this, see how simple the narration is. This is Surah Tawbah. Great Surah, yeah. You must read Surah Anfal, 8th and 9th Surah. Ayat 34-35. Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. To those who hoard gold and silver and do not spend it in the way of God. Hoarding, jo bacha ke rakhte, jama karke rakhte, announce a painful punishment. The day will surely come when their treasure will be heated up in the fire of hell, and their foreheads, their sides and backs will be branded with it. ये है ना मोबाइल, मतलब ये अगर पैसा है तो वो जलाया जाएगा, ये दागा जाएगा इस तरह कि ये मजा लो इस पैसों का. They will be told, this is the treasure which you hoarded, जो तुमने बचा के रखा था, जमा करके रखा था. Now taste what you were hoarding. don't taste this. Taste the good things of God. Quran Sharif mein beta, Allah aapko batayega what are the good tastes of God. Wo jab inshallah, when you'll be sitting to enter paradise, you would not have entered paradise yet. After your hisab kitab and the accountability, inshallah, when you'll be made to enter paradise, you'll be waiting at a certain place where you will have the first reception from God Almighty, jahan par Allah ka salam pesh kiya jayega, khane peene ki cheeze hongi, wo phir aap khayenge. You'll have those angels taking, bringing in different dishes for you and different drinks for you, and you'll be tasting and you'll be exchanging pleasantries. And after that, it will be announced, now you can enter paradise from any door you want to enter. And this is what it happens in the big parties here. When you go to a big major party, you don't enter the house immediately. For instance, in the garden, you are given some tidbits or some drinks, and then the doors are open, please come in and enjoy your meal and whatever. Develop a conscious relationship with these sentiments, with these things. Like I can pinch myself and hurt myself, tangibility of my skin and the pinch, the pain that I can feel. Feel the tangibility of paradise for yourself. Feel the tangibility of this treasure which we wouldn't have spent in the way of Allah, being branded by it with the fire of hell, God forbid. We have to be careful about these things. You don't have to fear that we keep a long beard or we keep a big abaya type thing and we just go shut ourselves from the responsibilities of the world. No, this is not God's design. God says, my maal, my wealth is my bounty. Seek my bounty. Through this bounty, make your life in this world a pleasurable place to live and the world hereafter. Kya problem hai, kare? The example of Karun. The fact is that Karun was one of Musa's people, and the details are there. I'm not going to go into them. It's a huge paragraph. These are the three slides better, 17, 18, and 19, and this is the 28th surah, ayat 76 to 82. And it says that Karun was very, very wealthy to the extent that the keys of his treasuries were used to be lifted by powerful people. The keys of his treasury, not the treasure itself. And he used to boast that I got this, all this through my knowledge. And his peers, his colleagues used to tell him, ask him, yeah, give something in the way of God. You know, there's some due share. Give your due share to the have-nots. He used to say, it's because of my knowledge. And one day, when he entered the marketplace with all his pomp and all his wealth, for instance, with his Prados and Dala and all these things that we have now. And God made him, he made the earth swallow him up in front of them, along with his treasures. And then those people used to relish his Land Cruiser and his Dala and his gunmen. He said, just thank God we weren't like him. But those people who realized used to tell him, yeah, give your portion of your sustenance that God's given you for the poor. So they realized that this is a punishment. So all this was in defiance of God's scheme. So through that particular incident, beta, now look at my words, through that particular incident which God has kept in his Quran, which is a reminder. So this incident becomes a reminder for us for all times to come. It should make us pause and reflect. The lockdown which is doing, the lockdown, the coronavirus lockdown, has made the world pause. Bad against Harestra. You must reflect. You know what people are doing, mashallah? In America, there's a beer by the name of Corona, Corona beer. And the sales of Corona beer has gone higher. This was a time to pause and reflect. But Shaitan has his own ways and means. He find pleasure in these things, in all aspects of life. So you have to, you can enjoy. I mean, you can enjoy people. There are so many videos coming out now in the Facebook and WhatsApp that people within homes are enjoying. They have found ways and means of enjoying amongst themselves. In fact, today my wife was sharing with me, very interesting, there's a man actually who is a chef or what, and he says, and I'm going to make some videos for the male people, like for me. I mean, I can't cook. I would have loved to cook in my youth and learn to cook, but for people like me, he has made those videos now in the Facebook. So I asked my wife, let's make me teach search some dishes that I like to eat, for instance. So see, the point is, we do not have to get drunk to enjoy a party. We do not have to womanize to enjoy a woman illegally. I'm sorry, we do not have to do something stupid, to sniff cocaine to get a high. We do not have to rebel against God to get a kick out of us, within us in life. No, these are satanic ways and means. Yeah, there are so much things to do to enjoy life. We have to make our heart and mindset to it. One of my people I know, my brother is an architect actually, he's a fine architect, mashallah. And that gentleman is my uncle actually, elder to us obviously, and he's also a very fine architect, he's Karachi based. And he used to tell my brother that, you don't drink, you can't design if you don't drink. Well, okay. And I've seen his photographs, and he shares his party photographs at times. He obviously is a bit drunk, because why do people get drunk in parties? You know why, beta? You don't have these, you might be having excess here, but it's not common here. Some of you might be having excess, but in the West, the parties are meant to have a wild time, and womanize and all that. Why? Because they think partying, enjoying means to get drunk, to get into this womanizing thing. It's limited to that thing for them, but it goes much beyond that actually. It might not appear thrilling, but this is what God has asked us to do, to remain with His, the precincts of His boundaries, precincts His boundaries. Usko aap tajawuz nahi kar sakte. Isiliye Allah usko address karta hai. Quran mein Allah says, yaar, in the that first reception, inshallah, in the Jannat, when you'll be given drinks, Allah says, I'll give you, you'll be served wine over there. The word is wine. But then Allah explains later, in the second ayat or third, that though that wine will not make you intoxicated, it will not make your mind go foggy or make you lose sense. And would anybody would like to lose his sense and different and lose differentiation between his mother and his daughter and his sister and his between and his wife? Would you like that? Nobody likes that. It looks very fine when you look at it on movies, or you want to have those parties. It isn't good. Just have your mother stand next to you, your sister, your father, your daughter, your son, your wife or spouse, for instance, or some other girl. And then you see, would you like to be drunk and address your mother or touch your mother? Excuse me. No, nobody wants to do that. God says these are impure things. Don't impure or pollute yourselves. Don't pollute yourselves. Relate to the lockdown. Pause and reflect. Do good things. Develop good habits, good activities within your homes. Do something here. Don't fret. Don't complain. Don't whine. Whine not W-I-N-E, W-H-I-N-E. Dogs whine. Don't do that. So, I've done that. Why the word zakat? Charity to hogi na, sadqat. Zakat ka lafz kyun nikla? This has a great meaning. The word zakat means purification. Purification, tazkiyah. Tazkiyah na purification. Allah ne ki wo ayat humne padhi hai. ताकि तज़किया हो और अल किताब अल हिक्मा तज़किया प्योरिफिकेशन तो ज़कात तज़किया से निकला इट प्योरिफाइज योर वेल्थ यू कैन अर्न बिलियंस ट्रिलियंस ऑफ डॉलर्स बट यू हैव टू मेक इट प्योर इन द आईज ऑफ गॉड ऑलमाइटी थ्रू चैरिटी इफ यू डोंट वांट टू स्पेंड अ सिंगल पेनी थ्रू चैरिटी गॉड विल नॉट आस्क यू बट ज़कात द मिनिमम बेयर रिक्वायरमेंट That you have to pay. Calculate through your saving over a year and pay. That will purify your wealth. And you can enjoy as much as you want through your wealth. You can get 10 Rolex watches or 3 cars, whatever. You know, that is, if God is giving you so much and you're fulfilling the rights through zakat minimum, you can enjoy as much. But then God invokes you. It inspires you to spend more. Over that, we'll see that also. But so it purifies the soul, it purifies your wealth, and it purifies your feelings. Allah says in the Quran, when he asked the Prophet Muhammad al-Islam that from your companions take sadqat from their wealth, so that they may thereby be cleansed and purified. Unko paak karein. उनसे अगर गलतियाँ हुई हैं बिकॉज गॉड वॉज ट्रेनिंग देम वो गलतियाँ करते थे ना मिसाल के तौर पर सूरह तौबा है जिसमें एक माल गनीमत का भी सीन था और इस तरह की चीज़ें थी कि वो कहते थे सूरह अनफाल और सूरह तौबा एक ही मजमून है दैट वी शुड गेट मोर शेयर एंड वट एवर सो गॉड सेड नहीं दी शेयर ऑल ऑफ इट बिलोंग्स टू रसूल गॉड एंड रसूल आई विल टेल यू हाउ मच यू गेट So he said, these kind of thoughts and feelings shouldn't come in your mind. So for that, he asked Prophet al-Islam to take sadqat from their wealth and cleanse them and purify them. So zakat categories, beta, are wealth in 2.5% of a yearly saving and on production, depending on its different forms, 5%, 10%, 20%. 20% is if you don't do anything about it. For instance, if you get hold of treasured somewhere, just like that, you're going to give 20%. If you get crore rupees, well, crore is too much for you, maybe 1 lakh rupees. What is 20%? 20,000 rupees. Yeah? 100,000, 20,000 rupees. You have to give it in the way of God. 10% is your industry and all that. 5%. 10% is your agriculture produce, in fact. And 5%, depending on the way you're earning and the ease and convenience of your earning, the percentage increases in effect. Livestock ke baare mein bhi there's a clearly mentioned law. So wealth, you've got 52.5 tola silver, we know all this, and you know 7.5 grams equivalent of gold or khajur zamane mein thi 1119 kilograms of date. So out of that 2.5% from your savings should go towards them. So whatever gold you have in your home, for instance, when you start earning better, whatever gold you have, you count them. If the gold is more than 7.5 tolas, for instance, if it's 10 tolas, then the zakat will be on 10 tolas, not on 2.5. You understand? 7.5 plus 2.5 is 10. So if you have 10 tolas, so the zakat is on all 10 tolas, actually, yes sir. Barali, you can see it. Very important, beta, very important. Surah Tawbah, again, ayat number 60. God specifically mentions six six types of categories of people to whom zakat should be spent on. It has to be collected by the state, remember. It says that it should be spent on the poor and needy, those employed to administer the funds. The Department of Zakat funds, the Department of Zakat shall be run on Zakat funds, actually. The salaries will go from there. Those whose hearts need to be won over the truth, jo Islam ke kareeb hain, karna chahte hain. Freeing the slaves and ransoming the captives. If there's somebody is kidnapped, you have to give money to them, or freeing slaves, unke liye aap karein. Helping the destitute and debtors, jo bahut gareeb hain, debtors, in debt. आप अच्छा भला इंसान, मैं अगर ये अच्छा भला इंसान जो बिजनेस मैन है एंड ही सडनली इज गॉन इनटू डेट, उसकी हेल्प करें. आप ये ना देखिए उसके घर में गाड़ी खड़ी है और नौकर हैं, वो एकदम 2 करोड़ के डेट में चला गया, समथिंग हैज हैपेंड. फ्री हिम, जो उसकी ये है फ्रीइंग ऑफ नेक्स. ये नेक पे होता था ना जमाने में बेटा, चेन से इस तरह बंद किया होता था और चेन होती थी, इसको फ्री करें आप. ये डेट है, स्लेवरी है. और इन द वे ऑफ गॉड, अल्लाह के राह में, और जो मुसाफिर हैं, उस ज़माने में ट्रैवलिंग वाज अ बिग थिंग, यू नो इट्स नॉट ट्रैवलिंग लाइक टुडे. आप तो दुनिया के किसी कोने में चले जाएं, ट्रैवलिंग वाज अ बिग थिंग. इफ योर एनिमल गॉट किल्ड और वाज इंजर्ड और समथिंग, यू वर जस्ट स्ट्रैंडेड एंड दैट वाज अ मैटर ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट लाइफ एंड डेथ. वो उन्होंने कहा कि जी आप उसके लिए भी कर सकते हैं. What are the controversies about इश्तिहाद, about zakat? वो इश्तिहाद करते हैं कि पहले वक्तों में, इश्तिहाद means extrapolate something that happened in the time of the prophet or didn't happen but something similar happened, so they kind of extrapolate, how do we relate with it now. So वो है कि industrial production वगैरह should be taxed according to the rates of usher. Or some say it is only applicable to agriculture produce, which is fine. Tax other than zakat, this is very important. The Islamic government or a Muslim government is supposed to collect tax, supposed to collect zakat, not taxes. But in our country, we have to pay zakat, we have to pay taxes. So we are burdened twofold. Zakat ki pay karni hai, tax bhi. So what do we do? What we should do is, we calculate the tax which we owe to the government and our zakat, and we deduct the tax from the zakat or the zakat from the tax. For instance, if the tax, your yearly tax is 5 lakh rupees, you have to give it to the government, for instance 5 lakh rupees, and your zakat comes to be 4,50,000 or 4 lakh rupees. समझ आई बेटा, टैक्स इज 5 lakhs, ज़कात कैलकुलेटेड फॉर द सेम ईयर इज 4 lakhs. सो व्हेन यू गिव दिस टैक्स ऑफ 5 lakhs, द ज़कात इटसेल्फ ऑटोमेटिकली गेट्स डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम योर अकाउंट. सो यू नो यू जस्ट पे 5 lakhs, ज़कात का आपकी जिम्मेदारी पूरी हो गई. कॉन्वर्सली, इफ योर टैक्स इज 4 lakh rupees calculated and your zakat for the same year is 5 lakh rupees, so you, what you do is, you know, you pay that 4 lakh rupees to the government, to the income tax department, you left with 1 lakh then, wo aap distribute kar dein jisko bhi karna hai aapne. So that is how, you know, you can pay the two together actually. ये है ना, वन व्यू इज दैट मुस्लिम रूलर्स शुड चार्ज ओनली ज़कात फ्रॉम हिज सिटीजंस. इफ दे आर चार्जिंग टैक्स, इट इज नॉट द फॉल्ट ऑफ मुस्लिम सिटीजंस. दे शुड कैलकुलेट द टैक्स सेपरेटली एंड पे द टैक्स ऑनेस्टली. इफ द टैक्स दे हैव पेड कम्स टू लेस देन ज़कात, दे शुड पे द रेस्ट ऑफ दिस अमाउंट ऑफ ज़कात. जो मैंने एक्सप्लेन किए, इट्स वेरी सिंपल बेटा. Some of the things were exempted in the times of Prophet ﷺ. They say they should still be exempted, but some say they should not be exempted now, because at that time, for instance, horses the, yeah, vegetables the, they could not store the vegetables, so zakat nahi thi, vagaira vagaira. These are controversies, you can read them. Ownership, tamlik ownership means there are people who say when you give zakat you have to physically give them in their hands. For instance, if you are giving this pen in zakat to me, so if I am the recipient, I am receiving the zakat, I should have it in my hand like this and I can do whatever I want to do. You will not ask me tamlik ki aap uski ownership karein. But there are people who say that you can give it to the NGOs like Shaukat Khanam, for instance. You just give it to a bank account in Shaukat Khanam and they use it. To usme ye hai ki wo kehte ji aap to ownership nahi kar rahe, but no, it's fine. You can give it to institutions like hospitals, schools and other NGOs to benefit the needy without making them owners of funds. So this is what I feel, and generally people feel that it's fine, you can give it like that. Zakat for non-Muslims. Look at me. Charity can be given to non-Muslims. Yes, Muslims or non-Muslims. Zakat, in essence, beta, is a charity. It can be given to anybody. The only fact remains that it is the bare minimum requirement. Hence, beta, it has a specific percentage. Just like namaz, you can offer as many nafal as you want. 100 nafal a day, 20 nafals a day. Namaz, 2, 4, 4, 3 and 4 jo farz hai, usme aap tabdili nahi kar sakte hai. Ek set pattern hai, 17 rakat, 2 fajr, 4 zohar, 6, 4 asr, 10, 3 maghrib, 13, kya khayal hai, and 4 isha, 17. You can't make it 15, you can't make it 16 or 18. Similarly, zakat is a percentage, 2.5%. You can't make it 2.4%. It has to be 2.5. So, hai wo charity. Isliye aap usko non-Muslims ko bhi de sakte. Iski badi achhi misal hai, very simple example. Generally, in our society, in our homes, our respectable maids or the people who clean our streets are usually are Christians and non-Muslims. They're respectable. They are our brothers and sisters. And if somebody, if there's a maid who's working in your home for a whole year and she does so much for you, and how can we tell her that this amount, you can't get it. And you're discussing it in front of her and she's so needy and you go somewhere else to give that. God doesn't work like this, beta. Wo Christian bhi in Allah ka banda hai. God doesn't differentiate like this. We have done religious differences. He says, had I wished, I would have made all one ummah, but they shall differ. This is God's design. Even amongst us, we are Brelvi, Shia, Sunni and whatnot. So we could have easily been a non-Muslim. No, we will give zakat or sadqat, of which zakat is a set percentage, a set percentage, to are the ones who are closest to us. You know who are the closest? Our parents. You can give zakat to your parents. You can give zakat to your brothers and sisters, your neighbors, your relatives. You just move outwards. Yaad rakhiye. Ab aapko main misal deta hoon. Aapne aapki jo maid ki tankha hai 3000 rupaye mahina. You don't give your salary through zakat. No, it is over and above that. That is a contract with that respectable maid. You have made a contract, you have to give it through your money. Zakat is different. You are over and above dena chahte hain, zarur de. For instance, your parents. Your parents are, they grow old, they don't have any source of income, for instance. They're dependent on you. You're also not that well-to-do. You have your wife and children to feed. And it is only through certain amount of zakat that you can take out that you feel that it will be appropriate to help your parents. Do that. don't let the recipient of the zakat know that this is zakat money. You can even say that this is a loan to keep the self-esteem of that person intact. यार ये loan है, आपने मुझे वापस कर दें, ना लें वापस, to keep his. You don't even have to tell zakat money. This is, listen children, please listen यार. See how God works. Do not relate God to how your heart wants to make believe Him working. इसको अल्लाह एक वर्ड यूज करता है अमानी, ए अलिफ अलिफ मीम अलिफ मान नून छोटी है, अमानी अरेबिक वर्ड विच मीन्स द फॉल्स डिजायर्स एंड होप्स ऑफ आर हार्ट्स दैट आई एम सिटिंग हियर एंड आई एम थिंकिंग Inshallah, I'm going to heaven because I'm a Muslim and what more, I teach Islamic studies and you know, I'm a big shot and all the other non-Muslims are hellbound. These are the false hopes of and desires of my jhooti arzu of my heart, amani. If you read this beta in your language, it will tell you it's not like this. God doesn't work like this. When you read about zakat, as God has planned it for us, you realize that yes, it has to start from my mother and father. If at all they require that amount, and you know, I can't give it from some other source. And my brothers and sisters, when I look back, I will look back is a metaphor, meaning that I have gone ahead in life with wealth and bounties of God. And they have stayed behind because they couldn't do well. And when I look back, I see my sister and brother. So I give help them and pull them along and bring them abreast of me. This is God's working. ये एक ऐसी saying थी हज़रत पाक सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की जिसको misinterpret किया गया. He sent a governor to Yemen and he told that zakat take it from the rich and distribute it to the poor. तो उस वक्त मुसलमान हो चुका था यमन और इसलिए गवर्नर किया था, तो दे वो था कि मुसलमानों से लिया, मुसलमानों में आप कर दें. ये ऐसा नहीं है, लेनी तो आपने मुसलमानों से है, देना नहीं है आपने, क्योंकि तो नॉन मुस्लिम से तो आप ज़कात नहीं लेंगे, दे आर एग्जेम्प्टेड. और एक ज़माने में हज़रत उमर ने ये एक लगाया था कि आपने नॉन मुस्लिम्स को नहीं देनी. वो एक वजह थी, इस वो जो वजह है ना, दैट प्रूव्स बेटा दैट इट वॉज बीइंग गिवन टू नॉन मुस्लिम्स. ही स्टॉप्ड इट फॉर अ सर्टन पीरियड फॉर अ सर्टन रीजन दैट कैन बी सीन, बट द फैक्ट रिमेन्स यू कैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूट टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट. देखो बेटा, आपके इर्द गिर्द जो लोग हैं ना, उनसे भाग के उधर जाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. सैयद को ज़कात दे सकते हैं, ये एक मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग है. वो हजूर पाक सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम जब प्रॉफिट बने थे, अल्लाह ने उनको रोक दिया फ्रॉम डूइंग एनी वर्क. ही हैड टू रिमेन डेडिकेटेड टू द कॉज ऑफ गॉड ऑलमाइटी एज अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ गॉड. ही वाज नॉट अर्निंग एनीथिंग. गॉड अरेंज हिज प्रोविजंस फॉर हिम एंड फॉर हिज हाउसहोल्ड. सो दैट रिमेन टिल द प्रॉफिट डाइड. I mean, nowhere is it written that there has to be, you have to maintain the record of Sayyids. And there is a record in the world's library somewhere, who are the Sayyids. No, it's not. But again, look at yourself now. You are a Sayyid. And your sister is a Sayyid, Sayyida, or your brother. And your brother again has fallen behind in the race of this life. And he cannot even pay the bills of his children and the utility bills. What do? You'll tell him that, bhaiyan, aap to sayyid hai, I can't give it to you. I'm giving to the next person who is not a sayyid. Does it make sense? It doesn't make sense, beta. ठीक है ना? तो ये आप सैयद का उसके साथ कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है. Or Allah, there are certain ayats now which you can read in 32 slide 32 that the 1/5 of the gains from the battle is for the Prophet alayhi salam, and then you know Allah has arranged something for the messenger, etc., his kinfolk, wagara wagara, you know, that it was specific for him. It doesn't go beyond that. Yeah. Acha, very important, but those who pay zakat can't receive it. Zaruri nahi. Beta, iska jo aapne point aapne yaad rakhna hai na ki yaar jisko zarurat mand hai usko zakat deni, beshak wo zakat de raha hai. Aap ye nahi kahenge aap sir zakat de rahe hain to maine aapko nahi deni. Nahi, uski zarurat usse zyada hai. And once you kind of sit with him or her and you ask, you sit in his home or her home, you realize ye to batti nahi hai ya bacche ghar hai school hi nahi gaye 3 mahine se fees hi nahi hai to yaar fees to hai thousands zakat us bechare ne saal ki uski banti 5000 rupees to 5000 to usne zakat de di na but yeah he needs 1000 rupees for teaching giving fees of his or her child in Lahore Grammar School and Beacon House and all these money-freezing institutions, तो फिर आप आपको देना चाहिए ना, तो फिर आप देंगे उसपे. Even jewellery भी हो, jewellery के ये मतलब नहीं है कि आपके पास jewellery है, पहले वो निकालें जी, नहीं, भाई वो उनकी एक self-esteem है. ये मैंने जो मिसाल दी है, 5,000, 10,000, 50,000 भी अगर पर year की zakat दे रहा है. But his expenditures other than that are in lakhs, like fees and utility bills, etc. You can give zakat to him. I mean, come on. Parents ka bhi maine bata diya. Achha, obligation of a believer to spend other than zakat. Maine kaha hai na, if you give zakat, if your zakat, for instance, is 1,000 rupees, Allah will not ask you in the hereafter. Aapne 1,001 क्यों नहीं किया, यू आर फाइन. बट ही इन्वाइट्स यू, ही इंस्पायर्स यू, इनवोक्स यू टू गिव मोर, बिकॉज इन अ ब्यूटिफुल आयत विच आई वुड रियली एडवाइस यू, आयत नंबर 177, वेरी लेंथी आयत, आयत बिर, बिर मीन्स नेकी, गुड, डूइंग गुड डीज. इट्स अ वेरी लेंथी आयत विच टेल्स यू द गुड डीज अल्लाह expects us to do. This is Surah Al-Baqarah 177. One of the arguments they present to prove their point is that in this particular verse, God has asked believers to spend in his way on the deserving people first, and later has required them to pay zakat in addition. Us particular ayat mein pehle aap sadqat dein, phir zakat ki baat ki hai. Theek hai na, obviously we gotta give beyond our help others beyond the zakat thing. This is so. Yeah, मैं आपको, अगर आप मुझे इजाजत दें, मैं आपको पढ़ देता हूँ. ये last slide है actually. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. They think that the duty. Shall I read the Urdu? Let me read. They think that the duty imposed on them of being loyal to God is fulfilled by merely observing certain rites and rituals. You should know that loyalty to God does not merely consist in facing towards the east or the west, ki aapne qibla ki taraf muh kar liya in the prayer, but loyalty is the loyalty of those who believe in God with all their heart and in the last day and the angels of God and in his books and in his prophets, and who, though they love it dearly, daulat, give away their wealth to kinfolk, to orphans, to the destitute, to the traveler, and to those who ask and for the liberation of necks, freeing of slavery and those who are in debt, and who attend to the prayer and pay zakat, and of those who make a promise, fulfill it, and especially of those who are steadfast in adversity, illness, and in times of war. These are the people who are truthful to God and fulfilling the promise of loyalty to him, and these are the ones who are in fact God conscious. Ye hain muttaqi log. Theek hai beta. So I've done zakat with you. So God bless you. Read the Quran. Never fear controversies. know your controversies and decipher them, absorb them, adopt them, adapt to them on the basis of intellect, sound reasoning, rationale, reference to the context with respect to the Quran. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.